Hello, this is Richie Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario RPG! Thought I'd start the episode today with me doing my 30 consecutive super jumps here. I'm doing this post-commentary because there is no way that I can concentrate hard enough to do this. Well, let alone to do this, and let alone the commentary at the same time. So, yeah, it took me a little over an hour to finally get a successful attempt of 30 consecutive super jumps. It is just so ridiculous how precise you gotta be with the timing. I mean, it's gotta be like picture frame perfect. I mean, it's just, I don't have any hints or secrets or anything that will let you do it. That's just, it just takes a lot of practice just to figure out how all the timing works, and it changes too throughout the super jumping. At least that's what I've heard, or maybe that's just people being paranoid. I don't know, it seems like it changes to me. But anyway, okay, so now let's head on back to Monster Town and get our reward for doing 30 super jumps. No way am I doing 100. No. No, that is not happening. It was hard enough for me to do 30, let alone 100. Okay, 33. There we go. I did have one attempt where I thought I had 30, but I got 29. But, oh man. But anyway, for doing so, we get the attack scarf, one of the best accessories in the game, especially for Mallow. Or not Mario. Mario. Not Mallow. Mario. And only Mario can equip it. That's why I gave him the experience booster earlier, because he's pretty much going to want the attack scarf for the remainder of the game. It is just obscene. So anyway, we also, last time, we also got the three flags around the world there that these guys hid. And for doing so, what do we get? Are you going to give it? Ah, there we go. I was like, where's the noise or something? But anyway, let's see what they gave us there. For some reason, they just equip it straight on Mario, but it's the Ghost Medal. So yeah, it gives you the defense up status at the start of every battle. So not bad, not great, but not bad. So I'm gonna take a moment to rearrange my party here. Let's bring Mallow in and change up my equipment, and I'll be right back. Okay, we're back. I got the work pants and attack scarf on Mario, because that'll boost his speed by a total of 35. 30 from the attack scarf there, and so yeah, that'll really help him out a lot. It also boosts all of his offensive and defensive stats by 30. Got the Troopa pin on Mallow there, boosts speed by 20. It also gives him the attack up status right at the start of the battle, so that's really nice there. And the safety ring to protect against instant death, and just overall status protection, things like that. So I think we're all set and ready to go for the optional super boss of the game. In order to get in that door, you need to have a shiny stone. You buy the fireworks at Moleville, give them to a girl, she gives you the shiny stone, you come over here, and you can open the door. But I already did that. Huh. Wonder where you came from. Kind of looks like a void or something or other like that. I'm not really a knight, but sure, why not? How hard could it possibly be? I'll be a little quiet so you can hear the music. Yep, they brought this music back. Nice touch, game. Nice touch. Hey, all right, we get a little freebie there. I don't think I've demonstrated that before. Sometimes when you use an item, you won't consume it. You'll just get another one. So, all right. And I think it's pretty random. Some people have said they think it's timed, but I'm pretty sure it's not. But, well, I don't want to argue about that. So, okay, so first things first. We want to use a crystalline to get all of our defense up, of course. Use a rock candy with the attack up status. And then we want Peach to use Psych Bomb. Just rapid fire or mash the Y button there, and hopefully we'll deal some pretty good damage there. Now, part of the reason why I have the work pants and the attack scarf on Mario is so that he can go first before Kulex uses his, summons all these crystals for him, and yeah, so that way I can get Mario's turn between the four crystals and Kulik, so that way, if they do something insane, which they oftentimes do, I'll be able to use a Caro Caro Cola or something. But first things first, gotta take out that green crystal. Gotta take it out, because that can deal a lot of the really nasty status ailments. If you can do that, you're in really good shape there. Okay, so next thing, I think I want to take out the water crystal there. So what I want to do is Star Rain. Basically, it's the same thing as Super Jump, except the timing isn't nearly as fickle, and you can only do it up to 16 times. So, but this is really easy to do. And I figured, let's try to get as much damage in on all of them as we can. Now, let's see, I'm gonna need some healing here. So, let's see, I think if we just heal up Mallow, we'd be just fine. The way you time that, just press the Y button right before the stars are gonna disappear. But let's see, that green crystal there, by the way, is the wind crystal there. So yeah, it has a lot of nasty status ailments, and it has the least HP. One, it's weak to jump, so that really helps out there too. It's immune to thunder though, so you want to watch out for that. Let's see, then we got the water crystal there, who is going to be weak to fire! So super flame, that's the way to go. Now Kulex is one of the very few bosses in the game who can actually use Shredder, which dispels all your buffs. So you have to rebuff with Crystalline. That's why I bought a whole bunch of those. I mean, if you're much higher leveled, you could probably use, whatever the attack up item is called. But since for this fight, I'm relatively low leveled, I think you gotta have the defensive buffs with the Crystalline there. And by the way, Shredder dispelled the attack up that Mallow had there. Even though it was on his accessory, it's gone. So yeah, Water Crystal also has the second least amount of HP, so that's why I want to go after that guy. And I'm just using Star Rain because it's non-elemental, so none of them absorb it. The Wind Crystal is immune to Thunder, the Water Crystal is immune to Ice, Fire is immune to Fire, and the Earth Crystal is, I think it's immune to Jump, if I recall correctly. Maybe I'll check that out later, but, well, uh-oh, this could really hurt. Okay, we're good. As long as you get the Crystalline up, you should be good. Just to reiterate, not only does it protect against physical attacks, but also magical attacks. And since I'm starting to get a little low on FP, let's use a Caro Caro Cola there. Not even for the HP restoration. I don't really care too much about that. Just for the FP. I suppose I could have used a Royal Syrup there too, but I've got these Caro Caro Colas burning a hole in my pocket. So now let's use Snowy to take out the Fire Crystal. Didn't want to use it before because, well, the Water Crystal would be immune to it. So let's keep healed up there now with Peach. Now, at this point, some people might advocate to go all out against Kulex because you've taken out two of the crystals. It's pretty unlikely that they'd be able to kill you at this point. And all you gotta do is kill Kulex himself. You don't have to take out all the crystals if you don't want to. Okay, gotta use a Crystalline here soon. Me personally, I prefer to play it a bit conservatively and just take out all the crystals one by one, especially at these levels. But if you don't want to, well, you don't have to. You can just go right after Kulex if you want. If you want to play it a little risky. Normally, you're probably not supposed to be fighting Kulex until way later in the game, like the end of the game. Your levels are probably supposed to be in your 20s by the end of the game, I would imagine. And, well, right now, I've only got Mario there. So, I mean, that does help, but I'm barely able to survive a lot of these, some of these attacks. You saw Mallow's almost dead there. So, yeah, I just barely have enough to beat Gulags. I have done it at lower levels before. I think it's a little too close for my taste, though. So I think this is right about the sweet spot where you want to be for your level ups there. Well, for your levels for your party. Somewhere in the upper teens, I think that should be a reasonable challenge, but not obscenely so. I don't think anyone should be dying here today. But yeah, just keep on going with Snowy. Jump on the fire crystal there. Best bet there. If you haven't boosted up jump, then, well, you probably want to stick to your physical attacks there. Because obviously the fire crystals are immune to fire there. Okay, so far so good. Let's see, let's just keep going after the fire crystal. Yeah, fire crystal's got a lot... Okay, maybe not a lot of HP, but... A lot more than the previous... Well, maybe not the previous two combined, but... It's got a lot of HP, a lot more than either of them alone. But anyway, now we got the Earth Crystal left, and it's weak to Thunder! So let's do that. Buff up again. My HP is doing fine, so I can afford to spend a turn on that. Uh-oh. Nice. This is one reason why I've got Peach with the safety ring, so she can cure the rest of us of our status ailments. Now, I think this guy's immune to jump. Let's double check. Yeah, it is. Okay, never mind. You could bring Gino to this fight if you wanted to instead of Mallow, but I like being able to take advantage of the elemental weaknesses. I suppose if you're only going to go after the two crystals, the wind and the water crystals, then you probably should bring in Gino instead of Mallow, because Mallow is really more useful for the latter two crystals there. See, getting a little low on FP there. Let's keep on going with just a physical attack. I'll use a Caro-Caro-Colo soon. Uh-oh. He's got his own star attack. I like how they got all these stars in the background. Nice theme they got going. But anyway, let's see. Let's go with a Caro-Caro-Colo. And let's see. Let's just use our physical attacks now. Yeah, whack him upside the head with your umbrella there. It's like a penguin umbrella. Now that would be pretty violent. At least from Batman Returns, anyway. But anyway, okay, so let's keep on going with Shocker. Oh, yeah, you know, I need to, I just remembered, I need to... Yeah, rebuff, because of the shred of it. But anyway, yeah, let's just heal up Mallow there. Timing for this, I think, is the same as the group hug there. Just before the stars disappear. Yeah, try to keep everyone above 100 HP. You should be in pretty good shape there. But yeah, you see how Mario's getting his turn between the crystal and Kulex there? So that, you know, just in case we get in the situation where we really need to heal up, Mario can do something there. Yeah, Earth Crystal's got the most HP of all the crystals, so that's why I'm going after that one last. Seems kind of odd that the crystals that have the more powerful attacks, or the ones that are, or the more annoying attacks anyway, are the ones that you can kill first. Or at least the Wind Crystal. That's really the only one that I'm worried about, because of the status ailments it can inflict on you, but... Alright! Well, now we're past the brunt of the battle, so down to Kulex himself. So now I think I'm just gonna stick to physical attacks there, for the most part. Kulex is immune to ice. Oh, and all of these guys are immune to all the status ailments, so yeah, no way you're getting fear or anything going on them. But he is susceptible to jump there, so I'm gonna keep going with that. And we're down to just Kulex now, so I don't think we really need to worry about buffing up with the crystalline there. So let's just keep on going all out. Now, Kulex has the most HP of all of these guys, but not that much. Well, yeah, not that much. Whoa! Oh, man, I barely survived that one. This fight is pretty much the reason why I went for the HP boosts for Mario, Mallow, and Peach there. Because, as you can see, I'm barely surviving a lot of these attacks. Uh-oh. That could really hurt. Ow! Maybe I could use another crystalline. Well, we gotta revive him first. And, well, we can't be that far. So, yeah, we'll be fine. I wouldn't worry about it. As long as Peach doesn't get killed again, I'll be fine. Well, good thing I didn't use the crystalline there. So, yeah, he just keeps on doing that over and over again. That's why I bought so many of the crystallines there, too. Pretty much just for this fight. That's really the only time that I think it's really necessary. Game? Okay, maybe I do need a crystalline to survive some of these attacks. I'm down to my last pick-me-up there. Can't afford to have her die again. I might just have her defend, so that way she doesn't take more damage from his physical attack there. Well, the crystalline helped there, that's for sure. I wonder if Thunder would do more damage than physical attack. It might. I mean, he's not weak to anything, but, whatever. Yeah, just keep on doing the jump. Great. Right after I use the crystalline. Thanks. Thanks, game. Oh, well. Yeah, why don't you just defend there, Peach, because we don't have a crystalline to help you out anymore. So, just sit tight, and we'll make it. Ow! Quit it. Now that wasn't so bad. Yeah, that wasn't so bad, was it? Hey! Alright, got him! Wow, look at that experience there. But alright, get a lot of levels there. Normally, I'd go for HP here, because you get a pretty good HP boost at this level. But now that we're done with Kulex, we don't need HP boosts anymore. So I'm just gonna send the mages down to get magic now instead of HP there. And let's see, I've got Gino with the experience booster, at least for that fight anyway. But yeah, now, instead of HP, I'm just gonna go for power for Gino. Although that was the power level up for him. But, alright! No, 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 he's not in another game. No, don't start rumors like this, game. Don't do it! No. Now, at least to my knowledge, Kulex is not in any other game by Squaresoft. But for defeating him, we get one of the best accessories in the game, the Quartz Charm. Nice thing about that, gives you the attack up and defense up status right at the start of the battle, and it makes you immune to instant death. At least according to the battle mechanics guide I got here, so yeah, it's really nice. And yeah, we can't get in there anymore, so... Oh, wow. But what awaits us at the top of the cliff in Land's End? Find out next time on Let's Play Super Mario RPG! This is HC Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!